What's up, everybody? Coach Kilburn here again with another video tutorial on Adobe Photoshop Creative Cloud 2020. Today I'm going to show you a little bit about blending modes. I'm also going to show you a cool tool that will perform some image surgery like a doctor would do, but digital doctor, right? And then we're going to do some image adjustments and change some colors and some other cool things, all right? So guys, first thing, I want to show you a cool tool. We're going to perform some image surgery. Guys, again, I prefer double column toolbox. Yours defaults to a single column. I prefer the double. It's your preference, it's your choice, right? Guys, this tool right here, the spot healing brush. If you hover over these tools in your tools panel, they have a little video to actually show you what the tool does. There's even a little blue link down there in the bottom right-hand corner where you can learn how to use that tool. So use these balloons and things in Adobe Photoshop. They'll teach you how to do things, right? Because I can't be with you all the time. So try to use these balloons, watch these videos, use the Learn panel. Right? Guys, if you don't see that tool, that just means one of these other tools is showing, right? Just remember that there's multiple tools. You just have to click and hold. So today we're going to use the Spot Healing Brush. Guys, your brush size, the brackets on your keyboard, the ones to the right of the P. They can make your brushes larger and smaller, so you can kind of edit your brush size on the fly. We're going to get rid of this word vacation that's written in the sand. We want the beach and the beach sand and the water, but we don't want that word. It's not going to fit with our image. So resize your brush just a little bit bigger than the area you're trying to get rid of. If you notice, my brush kind of covers the words and then just a little bit more. Photoshop's going to take the surrounding pixel colors, and it's going to try its best to fill in this area when I brush over it with the correct pixel. So here we go, all right? So I'm going to left click and hold. I'm going to swipe over the word, and then I'm going to let go. It may take Photoshop a few seconds there. It's making its best guess on what pixels. Holy crap, would you look at that? Guys, that's a really cool tool. You can do all kind of cool stuff with that tool, all right? So guys, we're going to take this image and we're going to put it behind this young lady right here, right? She is going to be really easy to select because there's really good high contrast from the color of her skin and this cloth here to the background. So the images you choose to work with are very important. I choose images where the content I want to use are on some kind of plain background because, again, I know they're going to be easy to select, okay? Guys, in our layer panel, she is only on the background. I got to somehow separate her from this black background because that's where I want to put that image of that beach, okay? So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to right click on my background layer, and you can convert that to an actual layer. You'll have more control over it if it's a layer. So I'm going to choose to do that. I'm going to leave it named layer 0, right? So now I'm going to create a new layer right down here beside the garbage can and trash can. The square with the plus will create a new layer. So right now I just have a new empty layer, right? And I actually want that on the bottom. So I'm going to drag it down. Notice the blue line. You can rearrange your layer order. So I want that empty layer on the bottom. I'm going to come up to this layer. And I could do one of two things. I could either select this black background and delete it, or I could select her and then select inverse and delete it. What's easier, two or three steps or three or four steps? Two or three steps, right? Save yourself some time, because time is what? Time is money, that's right. So I'm going to go to my quick selection tool, and I'm going to quickly select that black. Guys, I'm going to come over here. If you hold shift, you can add to that selection. So as I hold shift on the keyboard, I'm gonna add to this selection, okay? Now guys, since I have an empty layer underneath, all I'm gonna do is hit delete on the keyboard. That gets rid of that black background. Now how do I get rid of my selection? How do I get rid of these marching ants? I could come up to select and deselect, or I could just control D, which is much easier, all right? So now, guys, I want to come back over here to this beach water where we got rid of the word vacation. I'm going to select all of it. So you could go up to select all or control A, which is easier. I'm going to edit copy, or you could control C, which is easier. And then I'm going to come over here. I got to make sure I'm on this bottom layer because that's where I want the beach to go. I want the beach to go behind her. So in your layer panel, whatever layer is at the top is closest to you. Whatever layer on the bottom is furthest away from you. So I got to make sure I'm on this layer, and I'm going to paste that image right in here. I'm going to go to edit, paste, or you can control V, which is much easier. Cool. It's there. I think it fits pretty well. I don't really see the need to transform it, make it larger or smaller. You may need to with the images you're working with. If you need to, you guys, you can just go to edit, transform, and choose scale or any of these. You can do all of these in one step, or I like to do just control T. Control T will open that up. All right, but in this case, I don't need to. All right, guys, now I'm going to come here and I need to select her skin. I don't want to select this black shadow. I don't want to select the green area. So I'm going to come in here with my quick selection tool. I'm just going to swipe around. Oh, that doesn't work. I'm going to control Z to back up. I was on the wrong layer. Look at that, guys. Make sure you're on the right layer in the layers panel and then everything will work fine. So I'm going to brush over her skin and her face to select that. If I get into that shadow area or the green, guys, it's okay because up here in my control panel, my options panel, I can switch to the minus, right? And I can get rid of the green area. I don't want the green. Just swiping around. I'm holding my left click, right? I'm just going around. I'm performing image surgery. I'm a digital doctor. Okay, I want to get in here and get rid of the shadow. Boom, that's what I want right there. That's what I want, right? All right, so guys, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to come over here to this cracked desert sand, and I'm going to just control A to select all. I'm going to control C to copy. I'm going to come back to the image of the girl, and I want to paste that into this selection here. I don't want to paste it over everything. I just want to paste it into this selection. So guys, in this case, I'm going to go up to the menu of edit and I'm going to paste special. It's a special kind of edit and I want to paste into. I want to paste into that selection, nowhere outside of the selection. All right, guys, it's in there. I just need to make it bigger now. So how do you do that? Yes, control T is transform. Now watch when I resize it. It's not going to go into any other area. I can resize it and move it around inside that selection, and it's only going to be inside that selection. Pretty, pretty, pretty cool. Now I got to commit the transformation. How do I commit the transformation? You got to come up here and hit the check, or I just like to hit enter on the keyboard, right? So now I've got three layers. I've got the beach in the background, so I'm going to rename that. I've got the girl here, so I'm going to rename that, right? And then I've got the desert here, so I'm going to rename that. Guys, desert is with one S. How do you remember? You remember dessert has two S's. It's for strawberry shortcake. All right. So, guys, I have to use a blending mode. The blending modes are found right here. There's a whole mess of blending modes. Blending modes blend down. So since I want to blend this cracked desert sand into her face, I got to make sure the cracked desert sand's on top of her. Guys, you can rearrange layers by dragging them around, right? So if your layers are out of order, just rearrange them, right? Whatever image you want to blend, like a texture, needs to be on the top. Is going to blend down, right? So here's my blending modes. Watch what happens to that image on the screen as I go down the blending modes. It kind of shows you how they blend that top layer down to the bottom layer. Pretty, pretty cool stuff, guys. Pretty cool stuff. So guys, get in here and explore these blending modes. You're going to use different images than I'm using. Wow, those look pretty cool, man. Saturation and color, those look pretty cool. Your images are going to look different. You're going to use different blending modes. Woo, real dark and evil, right? So you do not have to use the ones I'm using. I believe I wanted to use color burn is the one I wanted to use. Color burn, right? Boom, and then it blends it there. Guys, pretty cool. Blend images together, right? Using blending modes, use the one you want. Oh guys, I'm gonna come in here. I wanna change the color of her cloth. So again, I'm gonna go to the regular quick selection tool. If you need to resize, ooh, I'm on the wrong layer. See, that's what happens. Control D to deselect. I gotta be on the image, the layer of the girl, layer of the girl. So guys, I'm gonna come around here and select that green. If you need to resize your brushes, again, do so with the bracket keys on your keyboard. I just wanna select all this green. Why do they call it the quick selection tool? Cause it quickly selects. I made a little boo-boo right there. Let me go to the minus, get rid of that. All right, again, you're performing image surgery. Again, guys, I want to slightly change the color, so I'm going to come up to image and adjustments. If you remember, this is where we went to the hue saturation and we did some desaturation. We did that last week. In this case, guys, I just want to change the color. So I'm just going to move the hue slider. What is a hue? A hue is a color. In design, we call it a hue. So I'm just gonna move around and see which one I think fits. And I'm gonna go with like a beige, tan, dull color like that maybe. Maybe a purple color. Yeah, let's go with a beige, tan, right? And then you just hit okay. If you wanna make it darker, add black. If you wanna make it lighter, add white, right? Okay. Now I can control D to deselect. The last thing I want to do is come back here to the beach and maybe make that look a little crazier. So I can come up here to image, adjustments. Maybe we want to go back to hue saturation. We'll see what it looks like if we just alter the colors. Yeah, we want to make it look like she's on another planet. So things got to look weird and crazy and trippy, right? So let's go with the sand being purple. Okay, cool, something like that. Boom. And then guys, I'm very prone to layer styles. I showed you some layer styles. Layer styles are found right here where the FX is. I really like drop shadows. So I'm gonna come and throw a drop shadow on this dark Sith Lord that we just created. Guys, this angle will control your light source. So you can move that. The sun is shining and it creates a shadow on the other side, right? So that's where I want to put that, right? Guys, experiment with your layer styles, right? Maybe I'll add a little stroke. Stroke is an outline, right? So we can see a little bit of black here. That's a little too big, so I'll just make that a little smaller, right? I'm pretty happy with that. Now I'll hit okay, all right? Guys, if you want to view your artwork in its full glory, you can go full screen mode. So which menu would we go to up here? What would make sense for viewing some? Holy moly, view. I'm going to come down to view, and I'm going to go screen mode and full screen mode. Bam, full screen mode. Now I can look at my artwork in its full glory. I'm pretty happy with what I created. I hope you guys create something cool too.